Sorry, I was muted. Is the screen visible?
Yes.
Sadashiva Samaramham, Shankaracharya Madhyamam, Asmadacharya Paryantam, Vande Guru Paramparam, Shruti Smriti Purananam, Alayam Karunalayam, Namami Bhagavatpadam, Shankaram Loka Shankaram, Shankaram Shankaracharyam, Keshavam Badarayanam, Sutra Vashikrita Vande, Bhagavantau Punah Punaha, Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti, Murti Bheda Vibhagini, Yoma Vadvyapta Dehaya, Dakshina Murtaye Namaha, Sahanavatu, Sahanau Hunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavaditamastuma Vidvishavahai, Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi, Yo Brahmana Vidhati Puram Vedagrishya Prahinoti Tasmai Tagumha Devam Atma Buddhi Prakasham Mukshuruvai Sharanam Ham Prapadji Om Shanti 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 Shri Chidghana Ganesha Namumayam Sukhan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupa Adhishtanam Buddhi Bodhyam Buddhi Durkyatya Nirvana Param Taru Vedanta Vidyam Pratyak Param Maha Tadeva Hannamattva Nyatiti Me Nishchitamatihi. So we looked at the Vivaranakara Samatha. So there is Sankshepa Sharirika, Vivarana Vedantam Muktavali, Advaita Siddhi or Advaita Deepikadi. Adipadina, everything that follows Vivaranakara. Grantheshu Ajnanam Swashre Vishayakam Iti Varanitam. What is the Vishaya and Ashraya of Ajnana? Ajnana is one, and what is its ashraya? Brahma. Shuddha Chaitanya is the ashraya, and Vishaya is also Shuddha Chaitanya. This is the Vivarana Mata. Uktarthe Vachaspati Matam. So Bhagavan Vachaspati Mishra differs from this Bhamatikara, and what is his opinion about it? That is being looked into in Avarta 257. Ajnanam Jivam Ashritya Stitva Brahma Vishayi Karoti. Ajnana Ashraya is Jiva, not Shuddha Chaitanya, Jiva. Now Jivas are many, therefore Ajnanas are also many, not one Ajnana. Thereby, Ashraya of Ajnana is Jiva. Jivas being many, there are many Ajnanas, and the Vishaya, however, is Brahma. For all the Ajnanas, across all Jivas, the Vishaya is Brahma. Meaning, Avarna is created on Shuddha Chaitanya, Brahma. However, the Vishaya being one, the Ashrayas are many. Ajnanas are different. Aham Ajnyo Brahmana Janami Ityanubhave Aham Iti Shabdhartho Jeevaha. He takes the same sentence which was given earlier. Aham Brahmana Janami here. So that is the Avarana manifestation. It was seen here as Jagrat Kale. In the Jagrat Avastha, Aham Ajnya Brahmana Janami Iti Anubhuyate Maya, which was said to be Ajnana or Avidya with a change in terminology. There is only Nama Bheda, but there is no Vastavika Bheda between Maya and Ajnana as per the Vivarana Karamata. Bhamatikara, however, says that Aham Brahmana Janami there Ityanubhave. It is true that Avarna is known, but Avarna is known to the Jiva. There Aham Padena Kim Ujjate. Aham Pade Aham Iti Shabdartha Jivaha Natu Brahma. That is his opinion, and thereby Jivaha is Ajna. Aham Iti Aham Brahmana Janami. There Aham and Brahma differentiation has been made. Aham is not Brahma, Aham is Jiva. Who does not know what exactly this Brahma Tattva is? Therefore, Aham Iti Shabdartha Jivaha Ajnaha Iti Ajnanashretuna Pratiyate. Therefore, one who has the Anubhava of not knowing expressing as a subject aham, he is the ashraya of ajnana because he has ajnana. Thereby, in that anubhava itself, whether he makes that statement or not, in his antakkarana, there is a vritti as aham brahmana janami. There, aham, he knows that it is me, not Brahma. Therefore, he is ajna, one who has this cognition that jiva is ajna, iti ajnana ashrayatvana pratiyate. Ajnana ashraya is known to himself because he says, I do not know. Who are you? He says, I know who I am jiva. That jiva is the ashraya for ajnana of Brahma. Ajnana, where the vishaya is Brahma. Tasma jivasya ajnana ashrayatvam yakti bhavati. You cannot say anymore that Brahma is the ashraya because jiva has become an ashraya. Now jiva becoming the ashraya of ajnana, there is ajnana ashrayatvam. That ashrayatva of ajnana being in jiva, jiva having that ashrayatvam, jiva being many, vyakti bhavati. Brahmana janam iti shabdai ajnanasya vishayo brahma iti siddhyati. And then, if you split the sentence, the second part of the sentence, aham has already been consumed. So, brahmana janami aham ajna aran samanadikaranyam. So, aham jivaha ajnaha. Whereas, brahmana janami, that second part of the phrase, iti shabdaihi, through those words, what is known? Ajnanasya vishaya brahma siddhyati. Vishaya is brahma for this ajnana which is individualized now. Tathacha ajnanam jivashritam sat brahma vishayi karoti, meaning avrunoti iti siddham. Thereby, jiva is ajnana ashraya and being in jiva, this ajnana veils the brahma, brahma tattva. This is established in Bhamati Kara Matha. In Bhamati, this is how it is dealt with. Now, if you look further, Tachya Jnanam na ekam kintu nana. Since jivas are many, in Vivarana Matha, Brahma is one. In Bhamati Matha also, Brahma is one. However, that Nirguna Brahma is not the ashraya in Bhamati Mata. Therefore, jiva being the ashrayas, jiva being many, ajnanas have to be many. Whereas in Vivarana Mata, Brahma is one, Brahma is the ashraya for ajnana, which is nothing but maya or avidya. And that ashraya is one, therefore, ajnana is also one. In Bhamati Mata, tachya ajnanam na ekam kintu nana. There are as many ajnanas as there are jivas. Ajnanasya ekatve ekasya jnanodena ajnane nashte itaresham api ajnanam tatkara samsaro vana pratiyate tu. His argument is that if at all ajnana is one, then that one jiva gets jnana. Somebody has got jnana today. Has anyone got jnana? Say nobody else, but Shankaracharya has got jnana. Then by that Shankaracharya, who you have to agree that he is a jiva, he is getting jnana. Jnanodayena ajnane nashte. Ajnana goes away. This is what your siddhanta is, which I agree, says Bhamatikara. Itaresham api ajnanam tatkare samsaruvana pratiyeta. Then one jiva's ajnana going, whosoever it is, whoever you consider your guru, whoever, his ajnana is nashta by jnanodaya. Then that ajnana going, it is one. Then how can there be samsara for others? Ajnana for others will also be nashta because ajnana is one. Therefore, others will also not have ajnana. If one gets moksha, everyone gets moksha. Samsara will not be there anymore, but samsara is there pratiyate tu. Thereby, since there is a samsara pratiti for other jivas, therefore mukta jivas ajnana, which is nashta, was different from the baddha jivas. Baddha jivas ajnana still continues, therefore their ajnanas are different. अद्यावधीन कस्यचिदपि ज्ञानं नोदितम् इति अभ्युपगमे इतः परम अपि न कस्यचिदपि ज्ञानं जायेत. एंड इफ यू आर्ग्यू ही सेज इफ यू आर्ग्यू दैट nobody has got jnanodaya till now, then it will never happen. If so far it doesn't happen, then it will never happen again. So there won't be jnanodaya for anyone. Meaning moksha will be impossible if at all you argue that jnanodaya has not taken place for any jiva. Of course, I mean, nobody will say this, but he says this is an argument put forward. Because there are pakshas analyzed. Do you say that there is one ajnana? Yes. Has anyone become mukta? Yes. Then, if you say yes, then everybody's ajnana should go. Because there is only one ajnana. There is no everybody's ajnana. Everybody has the same ajnana, it has gone. By one effort, by one jiva. By effort by one jiva. However much effort one has put, that jiva got moksha, he has helped everyone get moksha. Either that or you say that nobody has got moksha yet. Nobody has got jnana. So, ubhaya pasha rajju. If you take any option, you are in trouble. Shravanadi sadhana nam anarthakya prasangascha syat. And moksha will becoming impossible. If nobody has got jnana, then why nobody has got jnana? Because are you Baddha or not? Yes, I am Baddha. Then if you have Baddha, then Ajnana is not gone. And that Ajnana is one. Therefore, nobody has got Jnana. If nobody has got Jnana, then Moksha is impossible. If Moksha is impossible, then what this sadhana is for? Shravanadi sadhana. Why do all this? This is his mata. Tasmat. Sorry, let me mute my phone, please. So, tasmad ananta jivashritani ajnanani anantani. Therefore, what is the only possible conclusion you can draw? There are ananta jivas, they are ashrayas for ananta ajnanas. Therefore, ajnana is not one, ajnanas are as many as there are jivas. Ananta jivanam ananta ajnanihi kalpitaha ishvaraha api anantaha. Now this is drishti drishti vada paksha. Who is Ishvara? Srishti karta. This srishti appears differently to different people subjectively. Now Ishvara is kalpita. In that paksha, Ishvara are also as many as there are jivas. Because each jiva has a different prarabdha anubhava, has a different samsara, that the grass appears greener on the other side. This is what each jiva feels. Oh, he is better off. That Ishvara is partial. So my Ishvara is different from your Ishvara. So ananta jivanam ananta ajnanihi kalpitaha Ishvara. Because ajnana and maya, you look at it, maya. Maya vishishta chaitanya is Ishvara. Now this maya being ajnana, ajnana vishishta chaitanya will be as many as there are ajnanas. So jivas are many, ajnanas are many, Ishvaras are also many. Kalpitaha Ishvara, kalpita Ishvara, they are many. Tatha brahmandani api anantani. So each person's sphere of experience is different. So there are as many brahmandas as there are jivas. Yasya jivasya jnanam udeti tasya jnanam tadajnana kalpite ishvara kalpiteshvara brahmandani. So there shouldn't be a space here. Kalpita ishvara kalpiteshvara brahmandani chanashyanti. So yasya jivasya jnanam udeti. For whichever jiva there is jnanodaya, tasya ajnanam tadajnana kalpiteshvara brahmandani cha nashyanti. Then ajnana goes away and ajnana kalpita ishvara and brahmanda also goes away. Otherwise the same argument can be brought in. Ajnana Jnana coming up, jnana does ajnana nasha. Even if there is an individual jiva who has an individual ajnana, if ajnana is gone for that jiva, then ajnana karya also should go. Now, ajnana karya, if it is one, meaning one prapancha cannot be the result of all the ajnanas put together. In Bhamati Paksha. So in Bhamati Paksha, there is Gauravam. He has to think of multiple worlds, multiple Ishwaras. Otherwise, he cannot say one Ishwara and one world, but many Ajnanas and many Ajnana Karyas are one prapancha. So each prapancha has to be different. He accepts it. So he says that each prapancha is different. And prapancha baddha, prapancha bandhana nivrutti that is taking place is for a particular jiva. Therefore, that particular ajnana and ajnana karya, meaning prapancha, goes away. Including the Ishwara for that prapancha, because that prapancha will have to have one Ishwara. May or may not be jiva kalpita, but Ishwara is for a prapancha. This prapancha being different, Ishwara has to be accounted as different. So there is Gauravam. But he says that's how the system is. You analyze it, ajnana going away for one jiva does not take away the prapancha, ajnana and ajnana karya, samsara for other jivas. Therefore, you have to accept that ajnanas are many. And with that, there will be many prapanchas, many ishwaras. He says there is no issue. You accept it and move on. Yasya jnanam na uditam tasya bandha anuvartate eva. As for others, whose ajnana is not gone, the bandha continues. Now this is countered. Vachaspati mata asangatyam. Ajnana ekatvancha. Whatever Vachaspati Mishra has put forward, that is not right. Ajnana is one. Why so? Ishwara jiva ajnana kalpita ityuktihi. Ishwara is kalpita due to jiva's ajnana. In Vivarana also, it is not said definitely so, but it can be said that Ishwara is kalpita. It can be. Because jiva is Brahma Bhinna. That Maya Ajnana being one, whose ashraya is Shuddha Chaitanya, whether you say Jiva Kalpita or Maya Kalpita, Maya Kalpita at the individual level or total level, they are same. So whether it is superimposed in totality or in at an individual level, it is the same because there is no difference between individual and total. There is no other Jiva. There is only one Jiva. Who is due to bhranti caused by ajnana or maya, who differentiates between jiva and Ishwara. So that Ishwara is kalpita, as kalpita is jiva. So jiva is maya kalpita, Ishwara is maya kalpita, and where you take jiva and Ishwara as one, being superimposed on Shuddha Chaitanya, then there is Laghavam and there cannot be an objection that Ishwara is Kalpita. So, Ishwara Jiva Ajnana Kalpita Ityukti. But if you say Ishwara is Jiva Ajnana Kalpita, it's blasphemy. As per many, many won't agree. It is Shruti Viruddha. Ishwara is jiva ajnana kalpita ityuktihi shruti smriti purana viruddha. Nowhere is it mentioned. Nana Ishwara is also opposed to shruti. Ishwara anantaha pratijivam srishtihi bhinna ityapi pramana viruddham. Not only shruti viruddham, there is no pramana at all to say that each jiva has a different srishti due to different Ishwaras, or there being different srishtis because jivas are different, their srishtis are different. Their srishtis and the srishti that they experience are different. Thereby, each srishti having, each prapancha having Ishvara, there are ananta Ishvaras. This is also pramana viruddham. Tasmad ajnanasya nanatvam ashritya Ishvarasya srishte hecha ekatva abhyubagame ekatva abhyubagamaha api na sangachyate. So does not stand scrutiny to say Ishvaras are many. Ajnanasya nanatvam ashritya Ishvarasya srishtehe cha ekatva abhyupagamaha apina sangachyate. He has to take in many Ishvaras because many ajnanas leading to one prapancha does not stand scrutiny. It is against logic. It is against Shruti also. So he has to logically arrive at multiple Ishvaras. As many Jivas are there, as many Prapanchas are there, so many Ishvaras he has to bring in. That is Shruti Viruddha. If he says, no, there is only one Ishvara and one Shruti, that is also not possible because Ishvarasya Shrishtehe Nanatvam Ashritya Ajnanasya Nanatvam Ashritya Ishvarasya Shrishtehe Ekatva Abhyupagamaha. Acceptance of one Shrishti and one Ishvara. When you have multiple Ajnanas, which are Jiva Ashrita, and Jivas being many, there are many Ajnanas, their Karyas cannot be one. That is not acceptable. So that is also, that is against logic. Earlier Paksha is Pramana Viruddha. Shruti Spruti Purana Viruddha. The second paksha that you take is against logic. Tathahi Jiveshwara Prapanchaha Ananta Kalpitaha. Sorry, Ajnana Kalpitaha. Tathahi Jiveshwara Prapanchaha Ajnana Kalpitaha. Ajnana brings about Jiva, Ishvara and Prapancha. Their Bhedas also, all these as well. Ajnanasya nanatve ekaika ajnana kalpita jivavat ishvara prapanchanam api anantyam prasajyeta eva. Even if you do not say it in so many words, the siddhanti, vivarana siddhanti says, bhamati is also siddhanta, but when you do hair split analysis, then there is bheda. Although advaita tattva is not compromised, but when you get lost in the details, there you have to say that Aikya I agree with, but then your analysis by which you explain that is not right. There is Bheda there. Both will lead to Moksha, of course. It does not matter which Paksha you take to, as long as your doubts remain resolved. If the doubt crops up and you cannot resolve, then you have to take to other study. Whichever fits the bill, you know. Yakshanu Rupo Balihi. Whatever solves your problem, you take to that prakriya. Therefore, here Sadhu takes a very simple approach. He says, I agree with Vivarana Paksha. There is no issue if you agree with Bhamati Paksha. But why do I take to Vivarana Paksha? He explains that. Bhamati Kara has given a solution to a problem that we do not consider as a problem. And while giving solutions, he has created more logical problems and also Shruti Virodha. If he says one Ishvara, one Prapancha kalpita by many Ajnanas having Ashraya as many Jivas, that is illogical. If he says that there are many Ishvaras for many Prapanchas which are Ajnana Karya, because there are many Ajnanas, there being many Jivas, then that is Shruti Smriti Purana Viruddha. So he has got an Ubhaya Pasha Rajju as well. Whatever option he picks, it's going to be an issue. So this is a problem with any deeper analysis with Srishti in Maya. Who is this Ishvara? What is this Maya? What exactly is Ajnana? When you go into more and more details, you have to answer questions regarding Anirvachaniya Maya. You cannot point out that this is exactly so. That is what why anirvachaniyatvam. So saying anirvachaniya, when you start analyzing, buddhi brings up so many questions which cannot be answered. So somebody will be satisfied with some level of answer. Other will be satisfied with another level of answer. So these levels are levels of answers. Different answers are given for different questioners. People who do not have that questions can ignore that and move on. But what happens is that analyzing this and seeing these differences, people think that this Advaita itself is not right. And they take to something else. They think that this argument and even there is name calling. There is name calling also because this is one of the ways to in Tarka. It is not Siddhanta. When you are in Tarka, there are heated arguments. So there are other ways to distract in Tarka. It is only an argument to win the debate. It has nothing to do with the Tatparya Nishchaya there. So those should not be taken and one should not think that, okay, this is how they talk to each other. So I think it is all useless. It is only at that particular level of the debate, there is something mentioned. And someone else should not take benefit out of it. Especially others outside the Advaita Sampradaya or others within the so-called Sampradaya, but not following orthodoxy at all. It is okay to say that at one level I agree and I stick to that level itself. I don't go to the details. But if you go to the details, you cannot say both are wrong. If you both are wrong, you have to give another paksha. If you don't give any other paksha, then sit out. You have no basis to make an argument that both are wrong. And this is what happens with others where anirvachaniyatvam has already been mentioned. They say, no, you tell me whether it is sat or asat. We have already said it cannot be explained. Shruti herself says that it cannot be explained. And you want an explanation which is buddhi kalpita. We can't give. So you say, because you can't give, you are wrong. And then you yourself do not give any answer. Then you are equally wrong. So this is outside the Advaita Sampradaya. So Vishishta Advaitins raise these questions. All these seven questions which have been raised, they have only one answer, anirvachaniyatvam, which has already been answered, and then still that first point itself is bogus. Rest of the 6 points are even more bogus because they have dependency on the first point. So the argument itself has no logic. It has no logic at all. Why seven? You can create 7,000. It is all meaningless. It's just seven is just a number. Considered as great Purva Paksha and all that, it has nothing of that sort. So you study Advaita Sampradaya in depth, whichever prakriya suits you, you can stick on to that. If no details are needed, that is also fine. Anyway, so Sadhu is going to mention that Ajnanasya Nanatve Ekaika Ajnana Kalpita Jeevavad Ishvara Prapanchanam Api Anantyam Prasajyeta Eva. There is no way you can say there is one prapancha created by many Ajnanas. So you have to talk about many prapanchas. When many prapanchas come in, then along with many prapanchas, each prapancha will bring in one Ishvara. Ata eva vachaspati mishraihi ananta Ishvara ananta srishtaya uktaha. Even if he does not say it in so many words, this says what it means. When he says nana jivas, nana ajnanas, then this is the flaw which will accrue. There is absolutely no way you can avoid it. You cannot say ananta ajnana and then get away by saying one prapancha, one Ishvara. Won't work. Tasmad ajnanam ekamiti matam eva jayaha. Therefore, ajnana has to be accepted as one. Now, ajnana being one, what happens to the jiva who's got mukti? What about the others? Ajnana going away, others, how can others have samsara? This is why Bhamatikara had brought in a solution to solve this problem. So that question is still unanswered. Therefore, the focus shifts there now as to how does Vivarana solve a problem that is seen by Bhamatikara, which is not really a problem at all. So leading there is a comparison with Bhamati also. Ajnanasya jivashraya svavishayatva paksha angikaraha. Jiva is the ashraya as well as the vishaya. Ajnanasya swashraya. Swa is Brahma there. So Brahma is the ashraya as well as विषय विच इज दि विवरण पक्ष नॉट दि भामति पक्ष तदिदम एकम अज्ञानम न जीवाश्रितम किंतु शुद्ध ब्रह्माश्रितम एव दिस अज्ञान इज वन एंड इट इज शुद्ध ब्रह्माश्रित नॉट जीवाश्रित लाइक भामति पक्ष जीव भाव च अज्ञान कार्यम नाउ देयर इज अनदर फ्लॉ इन भामति इफ जीवा इज द आश्रय हु इज जीवा जीवा इज अज्ञान कार्य एंड ही बिकम्स द आश्रय फॉर अज्ञान हाउ कैन दैट बी सो जीव भाव जीवत्वम अज्ञान कार्यम जीव भाव जीवत्व इटसेल्फ इज अ रिजल्टेंट ऑफ अज्ञान हाउ कैन दैट बी एन आश्रय फॉर अज्ञान इट्स कारण तच्च अज्ञानम न कदाचिदपि स्वतंत्रं तिष्ठति दैट अज्ञान कैनॉट बी सेड एज कारण विच इज विदाउट एनी बेसिस देर हैज टू बी सम सपोर्ट टू अज्ञान अज्ञान हैज टू रेस्ट ऑन समथिंग नाउ दैट अज्ञान यू आर सेइंग भामतिकार इज सेइंग दैट इट rests upon jiva who himself is a karya of ajnana how can that be tasmat nirashraya ajnanena na jiva bhava siddhyet ajnana cannot rest upon nothing and create jiva manifest whatever it is bhranta we'll say that Karya. Jiva cannot be a karya of ajnana, which does not have any basis. Yadi ajnanam prathamam yatkinchid ashrayam ashritya tishthet, tadatat karya jiva bhava siddhyet. Only if ajnana can be established as being somewhere, then alone its karya can be talked about as jiva. Jiva bhava ishvara bhava api ajnana karyam eva. Both jiva and ishvara are resultant of maya or ajnana. तस्माद् अज्ञानं ईश्वराश्रितम् अपि सो इफ यू से दैट बिफोर जीवा इज क्रिएटेड अज्ञान इज ईश्वराश्रित एंड देन आफ्टर जीवा इज क्रिएटेड इट बिकम्स जीवाश्रित यू कैन नॉट से दैट एंड यू कैन नॉट से दैट इट इज जीवाश्रित इवन बिफोर जीवा इज क्रिएटेड सो यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट दैट व्हाटएवर वाज प्रीसीडिंग जीवा एंड ईश्वरा That is where the Ajnana is ashrayaless. At least before creation of Jiva and Ishvara, you have to accept that creation in the sense before manifestation. Both are anadi. Of course, all of these are anadi. But even in that analysis, when if you say that Jiva Ashrita, then there is a catch 22. That catch 22 has to be resolved there. Tasmad Ajnanam na Ishvara Ashritam api. परिशेषाद् इदम् अनाद्य ज्ञानं शुद्ध ब्रह्माश्रितं भवति एंड सिंस देयर इज नो अदर चॉइस लेफ्ट परिशेष न्यायेन इट इज ब्रह्माश्रित अज्ञान इज ब्रह्माश्रित अनादि चैतन्य अज्ञानयोः संबंधः काल अपि अनादिरेव अनादि चैतन्य अज्ञान अज्ञानयोः संबंध दि संबंध बिटवीन चैतन्य एंड अज्ञान और माया Maya and Chaitanya Sambandha, Brahma, Nirguna Brahma and Maya Sambandha is called as Kala. This Kala is also Anadi. Sambandha is Anadi because Chaitanya is Anadi and Ajnana is Anadi. Chaitanya Ajnana Yoho, Chaitanya Ajnana Yoho, Anadi Sambandha Dhira Jiveshwara Bhava Api Anadi Reva. So Jiva Bhava, Ishvara Bhava, which rests upon the sambandha between chaitanya and ajnana also has to be accepted as anadi so ishvara bhava jiva bhava is also anadi parantu jiveshvara bhavayoho ajnana adhinatva jiveshvarayoho ajnana karyatva vipadeshah if ajnana is anadi chaitanya is anadi ajnana is anadi chaitanya ajnana sambandha is anadi That sambandha karya Ishvara is anadi, another karya jiva bhava is anadi, then this all these being anadi, why do you say jiva and Ishvara are karyas? that karyatva vyapadesha is only because jiva and ishvara as karya are said to be only because adhinatvena adhinatvat jiva bhava and ishvara bhava cannot be talked about independently. They have to take into account other anadis. Although they are anadis, the anaditva has dependency on the other anadis. Without them, they cannot be there. Therefore, there is karyatva bhava. Aham ajna iti jivashritatvena yajyapi ajnanam apatataha pratiyate tathapi shuddha brahmashrite jnane jivasyeha abhimanaha सहैव अर्था अनेन वाक्येन अभिलिप्यते इति परमार्थः. सो अहम् अज्ञः, व्हेन भामतिकारा एनालाइजेस द सेंटेंस अहम् अज्ञः ब्रह्म न जानामि, देयर ही सेज अहम् अज्ञः इज जीवः नॉट ब्रह्म. देयरफॉर अहम् अज्ञः इति जीवाश्रितत्वेन यद्यपि अज्ञानम् आपाततः प्रतीयते, ऑल्दो देयर इज अ प्रतीति ऑफ अज्ञान फॉर द जीव as I am ajna, there is a pratiti of jivashraya, that who has ajnana, he says I have it. Who am I? I am jiva. So ajnana ashraya is jiva, who happens to be me. Tathapi shuddha brahmashrite ajnane jivasya yah abhimana. The abhimana with that ajnana, that aham ajna, their ajnana is owned up. I have this ajnana. There, that jiva owning up that ajnana as I have, having abhimana as I have ajnana, that jiva, when he claims it ajnana to be one's own as aham ajna, there that shuddhashrite ajnane, shuddha brahmashrite ajnane, abhimana is where? In ajnana. But that ajnana is not his. Ajnana is in Shuddha Brahma, which is actually his real Swarupa. Instead of having Abhimana, Shuddha Brahmani Abhimane Jiva Brahma Bhavati. Jiva Brahma Naparaha. So Jiva Brahma Bhavati. Shuddha Brahma Shrite Ajnane Abhimane Sati. जीवः जीवत्वं प्राप्नोति. सो दिस जीव अहम् जीवत्वं प्राप्नोमि. कदा प्राप्नोमि? यदा शुद्ध ब्रह्माश्रिते अज्ञाने अभिमानः भवति तदा. सो दिस अज्ञान दैट आई क्लेम एंड से दैट आई एम एन अज्ञ, दैट इज नॉट बिकॉज आई एम अज्ञ. जीवा हैविंग ajnana, jiva being the ashraya of ajnana, but brahma being the ashraya of ajnana, I who consider myself an individual is due to that claiming itself, claiming ajnana, which is brahma ashrita. Saeva artha anena vakyena abhilipyate iti paramartha. So what is the final idea there is that I have a pratiti of ajnana being in me because I have claimed the ajnana to be mine, which rests upon shuddha chaitanya, which is my swarupa. Ajnana karyatva jivasyana tasya ajnana adhishthanatva rupam ashrayatvam yujyate. So this ashrayatva, ajnana ashrayatva cannot be for jiva because this ajnana ashraya has to be adhishthana. Ashraya is ajnana adhishthanatva rupam ashrayatvam. So if you ask what is this ashraya, ashraya is adhishthana. Adhishthana for ajnana. That ajnana karya cannot be the ashraya. Ajnana karyatva jivasya, jiva himself being the karya of ajnana, तस्य जीवस्य अज्ञान अधिष्ठानत्व रूपम आश्रयत्वम न युज्यते. He cannot become the ashraya which is the adhishthana. Adhishthana has to be different. So this is the analysis which we already seen this. This is a detailed analysis of किंतु शुद्ध ब्रह्मैव अज्ञानस्य अधिष्ठान रूप आश्रयः. Therefore, there is no other option left but Shuddha Brahma has to be accepted by even Bhamatikara as Ajnana Ashraya. To this there can be a question. Oh, Shuddha Brahma is Ashraya for Ajnana, then you have Dvaita. No, this is what the others say and this is what even people try to resolve. There is no need to resolve. Ajnana is Mithya. Brahma is Sat. Mithya Vastu does not affect Satya. It cannot be counted. I can dream myself to be having, many citizenships across everywhere. I can imagine myself as being the emperor of the world, owning everything. That does not make me rich at all. So, Kalpita Mithya Vastu cannot be counted. So, this should not cause any issue saying that Shuddha Brahma, how can it be an Ashraya? Shuddha Brahmeva Ajnanasya Adhishthana Rupa Ashraya Aham Ajna Iti Tu Pratitihi Jeevasya Ajnana Abhimanitva Rupam Ashrayatvam Vishayi Karoti. However, Aham Ajna, when one has that Pratiti, that is because the Ashrayatva, which is Abhimanitva Rupa Ashrayatvam. Ajnana is claimed and that Ajnana, Ashraya of Ajnana is not claimed, but Ajnana Ashrayatvam has a focus in Ajnana. There the Abhimanitva is there. Therefore, when I claim the Ajnana to be mine, then I become the Ashraya. There is a pratiti of me becoming the Ashraya. Actually, that is because of the manifestation of Brahma as the Ashraya. Shuddha Brahma Rupa Adhishthana Ashritam Ajnana Swashrayam Brahma Eva Avrunoti. And then what is the Vishaya? The same Brahma is the Vishaya of Ajnana. Tarantaram Jivaha Aham Ajnaya Asmi Ityevam Ajnanasya Abhimani Rupa Ashrayo Bhavati. And then by claiming that I am the Ajna, I am Ajna, thereby he becomes the, there is a pratiti of Ashrayatva for the Jiva, and then he himself says that I am the Ashraya. And this is what the Bhamati Paksha is also there. This is Samanvaya. Samanvaya is that Brahma is the Ajnana Ashraya. Even when Bhamatikara says that Jiva is the Ashraya, it is due to this Pratiti that I am Ajna. Then who has Ajnana? Obviously, one who claims Ajnana, claims as I am Ajna, as an Ajnani, he alone has the Ajnana. So, this simplistic way of explaining. If you inquire into details, even Bhamatikara will agree that Brahma Shuddha Chaitanya is the Avidya or Ajnana Ashraya. This is a Samanvaya that Sadhu makes. So here he says that. We'll look at the Tippana later. Anena Prakarina Ajnana Swashraya Vishayakam Iti Siddham. This is not the Samanvaya that, the Swamiji makes. Not Sadhu mentioning specifically, but Swamiji makes that. Here, we'll look at it, whether Swamiji or I don't remember. We'll see that, who makes that difference. But there is a Samanvaya made between Vivarna and Bhamati as to before, if you inquire into details, then Brahma alone being there, Brahma alone will be agreed upon by everyone who is an Advaiti that Brahma alone is the Ashraya for Ajnana. And Mithya does not affect Brahma, so we do not need to explain how can there be Advaita. But if superficially, if you take as to the Pratiti, then yes, it is true that I say I am Ajna, then who has Ajnana? I have Ajnana, I have to agree. So when there is a discussion between two people, then it is always the Jiva who has Ajnana, he will say that I am an Ajnani, therefore I am the Ashraya of Ajnana. This is only loosely said, not I who am Jiva is the Ashraya, you who are the Jiva are not the Ashraya. It is Brahma Chaitanya which is the Ashraya. So that is the, looks like there's a typo, it is not 160, it is 260. So this has to be 260 here. This is a typo that I have also made when I added to the class. So there's 260. We'll look at the 260 next part. We'll look at the, I'll finish this also. Aham Ajna iti anubho balad ajnanasya ashraya jeevaha iti vachaspati mishraha ahuhu. So he says, Bhamadikara says what? Aham ajnaha iti anubhav balat. He makes that statement that jivaha ajnan ashrayaha. Why does he say that? So even when he says that, it is because of the anubhav bala. There is an anubhav bala of aham ajnaha. Ayam pakshaha mukshu buddhav sukham pravished iti taihi tatha varnitam. Why did he say that? Because this is for simplicity of understanding for a mumukshu. Easily it will enter the head. Oh yeah, whoever is ajna, whoever says aham ajna, whoever thinks that I am ajna, he has ajnana. Solved. The problem is solved. If you inquire further, then he'll also answer these questions in detail. Vastutaha tesham evam ashayaha. So what is his idea there when he says that? What is the reality behind such statement? Aham shabdasya vachyartaha antakkarana vishishta chaitanya rupaha jivaha. When you say aham ajna, when you say aham, that time nobody is thinking that I, Brahma, and so on. Nobody makes a statement starting by saying I who am Brahma, and further, I who am belonging to this community. So, you know, even in the India, you fill up the forms. Father's name, husband's name, this name, that name, all that. Nama Vyavahara is there. I belong to this community. I am a man. I am a woman. All these ideas are backing there when I utter I. Even when I wake up in the morning with Aham Vritti, as soon as my Antakkarana wakes up, there it claims the bondage and says, I who have this Sharira identification. Therefore, when I say aham ajna, there aham brahma ajna, nobody can make that statement. Because that statement is still aham brahma, you cannot be ajna anymore. As soon as you said that aham brahma, then jnaha will come in. You cannot have ajna in the vakya at all. Therefore, aham ajna statement itself assumes that aham is jiva bhavaha. Because ajna is following. Therefore, aham shabdasya vachyartha antakkarana vishishta chaitanya rupaha jiva. That being so, tatra visheshyamsha bhuta sakshi chaitanya meva brahma. In that antakkarana vishishta chaitanya jiva, antakkarana is anatma, which becomes the visheshana for chaitanya, which is shuddha brahma, which happens to be at an individual level called by Sakshi Chaitanya, the name Sakshi Chaitanya. So Visheshyamsha Bhuta Sakshi Chaitanya Meva Brahma. So the Brahma Sakshi Chaitanya is sitting as Sakshi Chaitanya in the same jiva. Tachcha Brahma Ajnanasya Ashraya. And in when I say that jiva am ajna, aham jivaha ajnaha, then that jiva already has the Sakshi Chaitanya Aumsha, which is Brahma. That Brahma which is Sakshi Chaitanya, manifests as Sakshi Chaitanya, am the Ashraya of this Ajnana, thereby Aham Ajnaha. Vishesha Dharmasya Vishishte Vyavahara Iti Nyayena. The dharma of the visheshya accrues to the visheshta in jargon, in laukika vyavahara. Iti nyayana. Using that nyaya, jivasya ajnanashrayatva vyapadesha krutaha. Whereas visheshya dharma, brahma dharma is ajnanashrayatva. Visheshte jive aham ajna iti pratiti hi bhavati, and thereby vyapadesha also as ajnanashrayatva. So it is loosely said, it is not completely opposed to what is meant by Shastra and by Vivaranakar also. So this is the samanvaya that the Swamiji gives regarding idea being same, the underlying current being same, because Brahmatva is there as Shuddha Chaitanya. शुद्ध चैतन्य इज देयर भामतिकारा विल नॉट रिफ्यूज बिकॉज अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्य इज जीवा इज एग्रीड अपॉन हैविंग एग्रीड अपॉन व्हाट इज दैट चैतन्य दैट चैतन्य इज साक्षी चैतन्य विच इज नथिंग बट ब्रह्म विच इज एन आश्रय विच इज द आश्रय फॉर अज्ञान सो दैट्स द आइडिया हियर वी लुक एट 260th आवर्त इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ सुखम नित्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापकम नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धेरित्यत्य निर्गुणं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः तत्सत् क्वेश्चंस सॉरी आई एम टर्निंग अप लेट एवरी डे जस्ट अनेबल टू मेक इट इन टाइम So I'll try, I'll still keep trying. Someday I'll resolve it. Hopefully before our Patha ends, Vichara Sagara ends. Before that, I think I'll hopefully be able to set the routine.